It's got camp set up. Super windy out here, but gonna go look for some deer horns. First shed hike of 2024. We'll see what happens. Hopefully we can find something good. But I just found out the elk tag that I drew, so my mind is kind of wandering off of mule deer at the moment, but yeah. Got 3 or 4 days to get something cool, hopefully. Got some browns hitting the ground. Just gonna keep hiking until my feet either fall off or I find a big horn. Well, got our first shed of the trip, 10 minutes into the hike. It's probably total garbage, but we'll take what we can get. Well, 3-point. Hockey little guy. It's actually not that old. Maybe 2 years. Sweet. We got a horn right here. See if you can see the tines through there. The white. Oh. Oh yeah. Check it out. Ooh. Thing looks funky. Heavy. 3-point. Look at that thing. Hard white, big gnarly base on it. Heck yeah. I was just up there in that last video. Found that horn right there. Walked way up on the ridge, came back around, came back to the spot. Thought, well, maybe the other side's over here. Boom, there it is. Big old gnarly base. Super cool buck. And giant, but heavy, hard white. I'll take that all day. Super cool buck. Look how heavy that thing is. Oh, that's a badass horn. Oh my gosh. Let's go find some more, huh? Well, that's all we got for today. 6 miles, found all 3 of those within the first 20 minutes of the hike, and then nada. But I think it's time to make some food and go to bed because I'm tired. Hopefully tomorrow I'll find a brown or something. All right, here we go. Day 2, had a terrible drive this morning. See how muddy the truck is. But hopefully today is the day I can find a brown. I'm gonna send it way back in here and see if we can find something good. Probably gonna end up doing 10 plus miles today and load up the pack. If not, I'll be pretty disappointed because that drive in here was not fun. Somehow, I just walked up on a really cool deadhead. Let's check it out. Came around the corner, I saw the spinal cord. Bam. There's a buck right there. Oh, that is so cool. Oh, man. Freaking stud, too. Big deer. He's got splits. 5x5 broken beam. Damn, that deer is actually way bigger than I thought it was. Holy shit. I get some cool video of that one. Oh my gosh. Such a cool buck. Oh, that thing's big. Broken beam. Splitting off his G3 on that one side. Little split here. Oh, that is such a badass deer. I can't believe I just found that. Oh, that's crazy. Hopefully there's some horns up here. I told myself, if I don't find any sheds today, I'll be cool. Because that deadhead is so awesome. But here I am an hour later complaining because I ain't found any sheds. Funny. Dang, boy. I found the bone zone. Miles for piles, baby. Let's go.
Well, I was heading back to the backpack to pack up my stuff and get out of here because I just haven't been finding shit. I saw like a 150, 160 type buck over here with some does. Still packing. So I know it's early, but some of these bucks should be on the ground. But I don't know. It's just not happening here. So I did just walk up on a horn though, on the way back to the pack. It looks chalky. A chalky 4-point right there. Better than nothing. We'll get that picked up and I think I'm gonna head back to my pack and get out of here and go try to hit something different. Maybe get into them a little bit more. It's a baby.
a little guy. Oh, there's another one right there. On the other side. Yeah, looks like the other side. 3-point on that side. Hard white, maybe. Yeah, it might be last year's. That's good. Little 3x4. Pretty sweet looking buck. Young. No mass, but heck yeah. I just left the truck 2 minutes ago, feeling pretty down about myself and how much I suck at shed hunting. And I just caught some tines right over here. Let's see if you can see it through there. Some white tines. Hopefully it's a good one. 100 yards from the truck, I'll take it. Looks choppy. A little bit chalky, but nothing wrong with that. Maybe no one's been in here. Heck yeah. Let's go find some more. Oh, it ain't that bad actually. 2 years old maybe. Cracked on this side. Yeah. That's what we ended up with today. That little hard white set. I picked up that 4-point and this deadhead. 9.5 miles. A lot of hiking. Not a lot of finding, but hopefully we get a brown tomorrow. Morning. Beautiful day out here. Sun just came up. It's super cold. Everything's frozen solid, but do a little eggs and bacon for breakfast. Then I'm gonna start hiking. Feel good about today. Hopefully we can get into some browns. I'm probably just gonna bounce around into different little spots and see if I can get into somewhere where the deer been hanging out recently. And yeah, that's the plan. See what happens. Boot tracks. Our worst enemy. I guess I'll go this way. Oh yeah. frozen. Jumps only, baby. Let's go. And just like normal, when you're least expecting it, I come around the tree. There's a side-by-side brown set. I cannot believe that. I was giving up on myself. 4-point on that side. Gnarly 3-point on this side. Crazy little acorn tip. That's what I'm talking about. I guess I should walk around a little bit more in here. Oh man, that is so sick. Not a giant, but I didn't think I was ever gonna find a brown horn.
First brownies of the year. I can't believe this. What a cool buck. Look at that, dude. Gnarly little guy. So fresh. Let's go.
Looks like we got another horn right here. Doesn't look very big. But probably last year's, maybe. Yeah, hard white 2-point. We will take it, add it to the pile. Yeah, maybe 2 years old. That's awesome though. Doesn't look like someone's walked through here. Sweet. The next guy that comes through here is not gonna be happy because I've got damn boot tracks everywhere now. Where the buck's at, bro? Come on. Just a bunch of freaking skinheads. Well, you're not gonna believe this one. I just pulled a horseshoe out of my ass. That's how the saying goes, right? I'm driving. I just left camp, drinking my coffee. Just driving around looking for a spot to go hike. I'm just cruising down the road, not really paying attention. There's a fresh brown sitting in the middle of the road.
I've been hiking. I'm at 27 miles right now of hiking. And I'm convinced that all the horns are right next to the road. Maybe I'll just drive around the rest of the day. I don't know. This is way more fun. A lot. Super bloody. It's got like, when they're really fresh, that like yellow stuff coming out of them. That is insane. Can't match up that brown, so I was just gonna send it in here somewhere. And we got a white horn down here, which is crazy because I didn't think that they existed anymore out here. Everything seems to be picked through pretty well. But hopefully it's a decent one. Just barely caught it through the grass there. Be sweet if I could find a pocket of hard whites or something. Oh, heck yeah. Good 4-point. It's a pretty nice horn. It's old too, really old. Dang, pretty nice buck. Old, really chalky. Super cracked, starting to flake off pretty bad. That's a good horn though. I'm surprised nobody found that before me. We found the jump. Hell yeah. We're paying the bills now, boys. Was not able to match up that brown, but I'm convinced there are more horns right next to the road than anywhere else, because I keep sending it way back in there and not finding stuff unless I'm near the road. But I guess everyone else probably does the same thing. They just assume that you gotta get really far away to find any horns, but I think the rest of the day I'm just gonna stick right next to the road, do little 1 or 2 mile loops, try to grab something easy and make a day of it. What we got?
I just walked up on a brown set that looks super nice. I cannot believe this shit. Oh, I should probably quit the swearing, but man, I'm walking along. I look down below me. I see that horn. I can't believe that. And then right there. Look at that. That is crazy. I'm just cruising along. I'm walking way too fast. And I almost just step on that brown. I've definitely been walking past horns this whole time. That's not a problem. I'm gonna have to stay here for a while. This is crazy. Ridge here somewhere. I'll keep you posted, but
I have a feeling I'm gonna be getting out of here a lot later than I thought.
A handful of whites and 4 browns today. So I'm pretty stoked. I know I left at least 2 browns somewhere that I couldn't match up. Maybe someone else has already got them, or I know I'm walking past them. Those things are really hard to see in that really tall grass, so I'm gonna head back to camp and I'll pull everything out and show you what I found, and then I'll probably pack it up and get out of here before it's too late and head home. The feet are tired, I'm tired. Well worth it though. Rich and sad. More like poor and happy. All right, here it is. Super windy. It might be hard to hear me on the camera, but that's what we're going home with.
We got a pretty good amount of sets, actually, which is surprising. 1, 2, 3, 4 sets. Pretty insane. Today was incredible day. Finally got into a pocket of browns, got away from the boot tracks a little bit, and it turned out to be a pretty epic trip. I got my ass kicked straight up for a couple of days. It was tough, but finally did enough miles that added up. So I ended up right at about 35 miles for the trip, 3.5 for 4 days or so. I was gonna try and get to 40, but I guess I'm just gonna be lazy. I'm not gonna make it to 40. That buck ended up taping 176, rough score. Only 20 inches wide though. If he's a little bit wider, he'd be right at that 180 mark. Got like 6 inches of extra. Badass deadhead. Some really good horns. I'm stoked. It was totally worth the drive up here. Now I just gotta pack all this up and get it home. Not really sure yet what I want to do with this video. I kind of just brought the camera with me for this trip to kind of figure out how to use it, because I've planned on taking it up to Alaska with me this spring, maybe film some brown bear hunts. But I really just want to start videoing all this stuff because I know one day I'm not going to be able to do all this, and I'm not going to be able to take a bunch of time and go hike the hills, whether that be for responsibilities or what have you, but right now I'm taking advantage of all of it as I can, and I'm pretty stoked with how this turned out. I might just keep the video so I can watch it when I'm old and decrepit. I might put it on the internet, I don't know yet. Maybe everyone will know my shed spots then. Unfortunately, it's kind of a double-edged sword there, but yeah, it's gonna be just some raw, uncut footage of me either picking up horns or my clients killing big stuff in Arizona, Alaska. Maybe I'll take this camera down to Mexico and hunt some mule deer this next year. Either way, I'm happy, and I'm just gonna keep taking videos of stuff that I'm doing. There's a lot of stuff I wish I could have videoed in the past that unfortunately I wasn't. A bunch of cool things with cool people, but
hopefully from now on I can capture some of these moments and try to document them and go back later and watch all this stuff and be able to remember those good old days. Days like today. Because days like today don't happen very often, where you're picking up browns in the middle of the road and, I mean, walking around and crushing it for once. So if I can look back on these days and watch this stuff, I'll be a happy dude. Anyway, I'll catch you next time.